This is part three of adding and subtracting rational expressions that have different denominators. We're just going to be doing more problems so you could see more examples. All right, here's another problem. Remember, we begin by factoring each denominator. We don't factor the numerator, so be careful. When you see this 3 minus 12x, don't factor that. We want to factor the denominators. All right, so we're going to rewrite the first fraction, x minus 2 over x plus 1. That can't factor any further, but we might need to multiply that by something, so I'm going to put a little blank fraction bar here, minus. And now the second one is, I'm going to put this in parentheses, this 3 minus 12x, just to remember about, we can remember, we're going to have to distribute that minus sign at some point. Now, we also need to factor 2x squared minus x minus 3. So you could do this on scratch paper. Let's see, I think it's 2x minus 3 times x plus 1. Let's check that. If you get 2x squared, the outer term is 2x minus 3x, which is a minus x. And the last term is minus 3. All right, so that's it. And also, I guessed that x plus 1 might be one of the factors since it was in the first one, and that worked out. Okay, so we look at the first fraction. I see I'm missing a 2x minus 3. So I need to multiply the numerator and denominator by 2x minus 3. Remember, you want to have the same denominator in the numerator and in both fractions. Okay, so for the first fraction, I need to multiply the numerators together. So think of this x minus 2 as the quantity. So you're going to do the FOIL method here. And I'm going to write the whole thing under what the new denominator is going to be. It's just going to be x plus 1, the least common denominator, x plus 1 times 2x minus 3. All right, so we need to simplify the numerator of each, and we're going to subtract, remember, the second numerator. So x minus 2 times 2x minus 3, doing the FOIL method, I'm going to have 2x squared. I'm going to have a minus 3x. I'm just going to write down all the steps. A minus 3x, a minus 4x for the inner term, and the last term will be plus 6. And I'm going to distribute my minus sign over here. So I'm going to have a minus 3 and a plus 12x. Okay, so now in the numerator, I'm going to combine the like terms. So there's only one x squared term, but listen, I've got a negative 3x, a minus 4x, and a plus 12x. So that's going to be plus 5x, isn't it? And I've got a 6 and a minus 3, that's going to be plus 3. And I'm leaving the denominator factored. And now, the next step would be to see, can you factor the numerator. So once you've simplified the numerator, then you go back and see if you could factor it to see if anything cancels what's in the denominator. Okay, so now here's how I do it. I think, well, if it's going to cancel with anything, I notice since these are two both pluses, it can only be an x plus 1. So I'm going to just take a guess that maybe x plus 1 is a factor, and I'll just try it. So if this is x plus 1, this would have to be a 2x to get my 2x squared. And to get my plus 3, then, that'd have to be a plus 3. And then I'm just going to see if that is the correct factorization. All right? So x plus 1 times 2x plus 3, is that equal to 2x squared plus 5x plus 3? And yes, it is. So it did factor. If not, I just tried those factors. If not, I could do it on scratch paper and try factoring some other way. Okay, so now, notice the x plus 1's can cancel. See, now that I've factored, I can cancel. So I have 2x plus 3 left in the numerator and a 2x minus 3, and you cannot factor that any further. Don't try canceling the 2's, the x's, the 2x's, the 3's. It's a whole quantity. Notice, originally, you've got the 2x plus 3 in parentheses. That means you can only cancel that with another 2x plus 3. So this is your final answer, 2x plus 3 over 2x minus 3. I'd suggest you try this one all on your own, see if you can get it. You've seen the steps, you can go back and look it over again, but this is a good one to try all on your own. All right, here's another kind of problem. 2 over x plus 10 over x minus 3 plus 4. Now, notice the third term here doesn't look like a fraction, but you could write that as 4 over 1, and that's how I suggest you do that. So, if we do that, we're going to write each in factored form, and of course, x is already factored, and we're going to leave space so that we can multiply each by something to get a common denominator, because I see I don't have a common denominator yet. And remember, you can write this as 4 over 1 times something. All right. So if you look at the first denominator of the x, it looks over and it sees there's an x minus 3 as a factor. It needs to have that. So I multiply the top and bottom by x minus 3 and a 1. You don't have to worry about that. Everything has a factor of 1 in it. It's kind of the invisible factor. So the least common denominator is going to be x times x minus 3. So for my second fraction, I've got the x minus 3. I'm going to need to multiply the top and bottom by an x. And for the third fraction, or the 4, you don't have either. So you're going to have to multiply by the x and the x minus 3. All right, so now you see they all have the same denominator. So I could write it all over one common denominator, which is x times x minus 3. Notice I don't write the 1 in there. You never write a 1 as a factor. All right, so I need to simplify each numerator and then add or subtract if there was a subtraction sign. So in the first fraction, I've got to do the 2 times x minus 3. So that's 2x minus 6 plus, second fraction is just 10x. And the third fraction, I'm going to think of this as 4x times x minus 3. If you want, you could do the x times x minus 3 and then multiply by 4, but it's easier to do the 4 times x first. So 4x, right? So you're going to think of this together as 4x times x will be 4x squared plus, oops, not going to be plus, minus. 4x times 3 is going to be minus 12x. And we still have to finish simplifying the numerator. So there's only one x squared term, the 4x squared. And let's see, I've got 2x plus 10x, which is 12x, and I've got a minus 12x. Oh, so those are gone, and I have a minus 6 all over x times x minus 3. Now, the last thing you need to do is see if anything's going to cancel with a numerator and denominator. Okay. So, can you factor the numerator out? I don't know why I put the parentheses there. Can you factor anything out of the numerator? Well, you could factor out a 2, right? So this is 2, and that would give you 2x squared minus 3, but that's still not going to cancel with anything in the denominator, right? None of those factors are exactly the same. So this is actually your final answer here. You can write your final answer either of these ways. The 4x squared minus 6 over x times x minus 3, or you could leave it in the factored form. Both of those are correct. And also the denominator, if you wanted, you could multiply those out, but it's totally unnecessary.